about big things they're gonna do. Oh, they've been through it all. We can just we don't have to prove ourselves worthy of their approval. You're only young ones. Well, that's one point of view. It's all right if we've nothing better to do. Where's the crime in wasting time? Where's the crime in wasting time? Where's the crime wasting time?
Enjoyed the little modest welcoming celebrations outside for Martin tonight. Welcome to the second in this series of artist lectures at the AA. Martin, who's come here tonight, works in a variety of media, from sculpture and installation to photography and text. He's exhibited and performed in Britain and abroad, most recently at the Cabinet Gallery and in the 1998 Sydney Biennale. The composition and performance of music plays a central role in his practice and also finds expression in his the part he plays in his band. This autumn he's exhibiting and performing, well, he has been exhibiting and performing in Toronto, New York and Los Angeles. And in January 2000 he'll be the subject of a major solo exhibition at the Southampton City Art Gallery, which will eventually make its way to Camden Art Centre later in the year. For the meantime, I'd like to, if you could join in welcoming Martin Creed to the AA tonight.
Hello. 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 Hello.
Some slides of pieces of pieces of work, I suppose, but of things I have tried to make. I mean, one of the few things which I feel like I know is that I want to make things. I'm not sure exactly why I want to make things, but I think that I think that it's got something to do with people. I mean, I think I want to make things because I want to try to communicate with other people, or else because I want to be loved, or because I want to try to express myself, or something like that. So I know that I want to, I know that I want to make things, but other than that, I don't feel like I I don't feel like I know. I mean, I don't know what to make or how to make it or what to make it from. I find it difficult to choose, to judge, to say that one thing is more important than another thing. But if you want to make things, I mean, if you want to do anything or make anything, you have to be able to choose or make decisions. And that's the problem. So, each work is an attempt to make enough decisions to be able to come up with something. And I find it useful to have a starting point. So, in the case of this work here, the starting point was the wall. This was an attempt to make something for a wall. And I felt like it was okay to try to make something for a wall because people can see things when they're on walls. And people can see things when they're on walls because of the way their eyes face out of their head. So I started with the wall. So I just had to decide, what I was going to do on the wall. I was trying to choose what material to use, what shape to use, and how big to make the thing, whatever it was. Anyway, I couldn't decide what material to use, so I used the same material as the wall. So here, this is viewed from the side. This is viewed from the front. This is a three-quarter view from slightly further back. And this is a side view from even further back. So I couldn't decide what material to use, so I decided to use the same material as the wall. And the shape, this kind of bell shape, I felt was a good way to come out from the wall. It's the same curve that comes out from the wall, goes round and goes back. It was an attempt to have something happen on the wall in the smoothest, simplest way, and it all happens in a circle so that it's equal in all directions. This was another work which uses the same shape, and again it started out as an attempt to make something for a wall. These are very small, these are like 4 inches, there they are on the corner. 4 inches in diameter. So again, I was trying to make something for the wall. And I decided that if you take the surface of a wall, I could do two things. I could go in from it or I could come out from it. And I could not choose between the two. So it's the same shape, one going in and the other coming out. So that shape on the left is the one going in. And then I just looked for two materials to use. And the one on the left is silver and the one on the right is gold. I just was looking for a pair of materials that I thought went together. Gold and silver, I felt that was okay. You know, I didn't think of that as a decision really, because I felt like they go together. But to go back to this one, once I decided on the shape and on the material, I then had to choose what size to make it. You know, it could have been much bigger or even smaller. And I determined the size of it by taking the dimensions of a ruler sleeve, like just a standard painting ruler. And I made sure that the curve was bigger, was of a bigger radius than that of the painting ruler, so that when you paint over it, the ruler doesn't get stuck. So in a way, it was a very practical decision. I mean, I used to do a lot of painting and decorating jobs, and when you paint someone's house, well, when I painted people's houses, it was always a pain to take the pictures off the wall and then put them back up again after you've painted. And this this piece of work is just whatever colour the wall is, so you just paint over it if you decorate it. This is a sheet of A4 paper crumpled into a ball. I made this when I didn't have very much money. but it was just very much like the other work started with the wall. This started from a piece of paper. And the ball seemed like the most, like the simplest shape I could make from a sheet of A4 paper. Because I think it bothered me that A4 paper, one dimension is longer than the other. This. Was like the first piece of music that I wrote. And so this is for piano. It's a very short piece. And so starting from the piano, I was just trying to choose what notes to play and what order to play them in. How quickly and how loudly, and I didn't feel able to decide, so this is the middle note on the piano, or rather middle C in music, which is near the middle of the piano, halfway between the bass, treble, clef. So this is middle C played played once at a moderate speed, half quietly or half loudly. And in musical notation, there is no, in the traditional Italian musical notation, like MP is mezzo piano, which means half quiet. In this notation, there is no word for middle loudness. So that's why it says MP or MA. This is a very small 1-inch cube made from masking tape. So this is 1-inch masking tape cut up into 1-inch squares and then piled up to make a 1-inch cube. And I was thinking about how when you make something, whatever you make, how it joins with the world. You know, when you make something, it's always you're always making something extra for the world. You're adding something, and I was wondering how it joins with the world, and in this case, literally how it joins. I was looking for materials to use. I was looking at adhesives and all kind of joining materials, and in the end I used masking tape because I felt like tape because it's so thin gave me a way of building something up, but also I used masking tape just because to me it was the most normal tape that you could get. And a lot of the decisions are made in the work, some of the decisions are made because to me normal is good. So the cube was made because I felt like it was the simplest shape I could make from this roll of 1-inch masking tape. So there's about 200 layers in this 1-inch cube, and I kind of thought of it as I made one of them, and I kind of thought of it as a stick-on thing for the world, but I didn't know where to stick it. So in the end I stuck it in the middle of a wall. So yeah, in the middle of a wall, not on the left, not on the right. But then I couldn't decide what wall to put it on. So I put one in the middle of every wall. So these are in the middle of the wall, measured horizontally, but not measured vertically, because in this building all the walls were different heights. So I chose a kind of human height for the cubes. So this is one inch cube of masking tape in the middle of every wall in a building. This is an art collector's building where he has his business. So there were about 300 cubes. And when I was doing this, once I've decided to put one in the in the middle of every wall, I had to decide I had to make rules for the work. I had to decide what constituted a wall, and I decided that any break, like a pipe or a mirror, any vertical break in the wall, divided it into another section of wall. So in these kind of places, like the toilets, there were a lot of cubes. And that's the team of people. But before, is this in focus? Oh. Before I made that work, the first time I did it, I put one cube in the middle of every wall in just a single room, and this was a group exhibition. Where I got there first and put a cube in the middle of every wall, and then the other work was hung around it, or in some, like the painting on the right hand side was actually put over one of the cubes. I'm going to play a piece of music now, which was the first piece of music which I recorded. And it's a piece for drums, using a drum machine. And was trying to, I mean, I tried to compose a piece of music for this drum machine, which I got. But anyway, I couldn't decide which drum sounds to use, so I used all of them. So what you're about to hear is all the sounds on a drum machine. Each sound is played once, and they're played in the order that they come in the manual. So sound one is first, and sound number two is second, and so on. That gave me the order of the composition, but the speed of this piece is determined by the length which I decided it would be, which is 1 minute. And 1 minute was chosen just as a simple unit of time. That's what I mean by that's what I try to mean when I say normal. So it's 1 minute long, which determines the speed of it. So can you play a cassette? This slide is of a floor sculpture which I made. It's a cube, and it uses a cube just as a simple unit, the simplest shape that I felt I could make. But it came about, I did this in a group exhibition which was in someone's apartment in Amsterdam, and it was a very awkward, it was kind of one of those old Amsterdam flats, which is all kind of small and awkward. This work, I was kind of working, it came about through trying to work backwards from the end, I think that's right. I was trying to make something that was in the most difficult place. So instead of making a picture or whatever, putting it up so that people can see it, so that people can see it at their at its best. I just tried to make something that was in the worst place it could be, the most awkward place. And this toilet in the flat was really kind of small. There was where the sink is right above the toilet, and when you sit down on the toilet, your knees touch the door. You can't really close the door. So I bought the same tiles as the floor was made from, and made a cube. Which is stuck together with tile adhesive and it's stuck to the floor in what I thought was the most awkward place. And this can be made on any tiled floor, so it comes with instructions to use the same tiles as the existing tiles, and to make a cube and to situate it in the most awkward place. This is a doorstop, which I moved from its original position next to the wall, stopping the door handle from touching the wall, to a position where it only let the door open halfway. And again, you know, like all the work, this was an attempt to make something. But I think the difference with this work was that I was trying not to choose any materials. I mean, I feel anxious about making choices, about deciding, about saying one thing's more important than another thing. And so if I can not choose a material, then it causes me less anxiety. So this was just a matter of moving something that was already there. And so in a way, I think that instead of being an attempt to make something, it was more like an attempt to make something happen. And the thing that happens is a little awkwardness when you enter the building. This was like on the front door of a gallery. This is another work that uses stuff that's there. I was asked to do an exhibition, and I really did not want to bring stuff into the gallery. Extra stuff, and I decided to try to somehow use what was there. And in the end, I used the sounds. So in the main gallery, there was a speaker. And I mic'd up all the sources of sound that I could find in the gallery, and then they were all mixed and broadcast live into the gallery space, not recorded. So the sound of the phone, the computers, the photocopier, the fax machine, and the toilet. So if someone went to the toilet and the phone rang at the same time, it was all mixed together. Yeah, this is a work which is called The Lights Going On and Off. So this is a slide with the lights on, and here the lights are off. So it slides a bit out. And this took a 1 minute, again, 1 minute as a unit of time. So the divided in two, so the lights were on for 30 seconds and then off for 30 seconds, on, off. And originally I made it in a group exhibition, so in the 30 seconds when the lights were on, there was time to see the work. In a lot of the work, I try to get into the work a kind of equal positive and negative. And I try to do that because I don't feel sure. You know, I don't feel sure whether to have the lights on or off. So I have them on and off alternately. The same with the in and out. In and out of the wall. And to me, me, it's a bit like trying to. It's a bit like trying to make something and trying not to make it at the same time, trying to make it and trying to unmake it. And to me, the perfect situation is that somehow I can. The perfect situation would be that I could make something and end up back at the point where I hadn't made it. You know, I think of the work as being like a kind of, in a way I think it's like a kind of equation where you start from zero. It's like zero plus one minus one equals zero. So you start from zero and you get back to zero, but in the middle you've got the equation and so something has happened, and that's the work. This is a door opening and closing and a light going on and off. So using an automatic door device, I made this door open and close. So it's constantly opening and closing. It was a door in the gallery. And the light in the room beyond is going on and off. Not exactly in sync, but for each opening and closing of the door, there was an on and off of the light. So it was like a kind of duet between the door and the light. So the music, I think similarly in the music, I often try to get an equal, somehow try and get an equal positive and negative into it. And in some of the pieces that I've written, there is literally equal silence to sound, so that each instrument played rests for as long as it plays. And I'd like to play a song, and I'm not sure which one. I'm going to have a look. So this piece is for bass guitar and drums. It's instrumental. I think again I took like the bass guitar, lead guitar and drums as being a kind of given or a normal band setup. You've got bass, you've got treble and you've got rhythm. And this piece was one of the first pieces that I wrote, and I suppose it was a kind of attempt to write a guitar solo. So I couldn't decide what notes to play. So this is all the notes on the guitar played from the bottom to the top and back again. And in the background, the bass and the drums are kind of going on and off. They're playing and then resting, playing, resting, playing, resting. So the guitar starts from the bottom, goes up to the top and comes back down again, and the bass guitar does the same. It plays open strings from the lowest to the highest and back again. And the drums do the same. They start from the bass drum, go up to the hi-hat and back down again. So this is called Up and Down, and it's track 7. Thank you. long time I've been trying to make her work using air, because I think that air, to me, air is the perfect material because it's not a choice. we don't have a choice about air. I mean, we need it, and it's everywhere. If it wasn't for air, you wouldn't have been able to hear the music just then. I've been looking for a way, trying to use air, and in the end, I felt like the simplest way to contain air or to package it was to use balloons. So I'm going to show you a little bit of a video, which is of an installation which uses balloons, and it's called Half the Air in a Given Space. So it can be done in any, like a lot of the work, it can be done in any, like the door work can be done on any door. This work can be done in any volume of, contained volume of space. And I calculated the volume of the whole space, and then I filled half of it with balloons. So the place is half filled with balloons. So can you play the video? Partly because I wanted to make the work and not make it so that So half the space is just air, half of it is air inside balloons. But also because if I'd filled the space, people would not have been able to get in. And that work on video, that was multicoloured balloons, because I couldn't decide what colour to use. But I've made a number of, the first one I did was white, because I couldn't decide what colour to use. And then I did multicoloured. The only real choice has been the red one, but I felt like red was the colour that balloons usually are. I might be wrong, but if they're a colour, then they're usually red. But I did this in Turin, in Italy, home of the Red Brigade and Ferrari. That's the gallerist in his office. That's him on the telephone. So this is black balloons in Finland. This was the first one that I did. So this was probably about 12,000 white balloons. And they were just standard 12-inch party balloons. So I'm going to play a little song now, and this song has words. No, first I'll play something from CD, which is the first piece I wrote which had words. A lot of the pieces were instrumental, because I couldn't decide what what to say. So this was an attempt to write lyrics. It's track number two. It's called track number two. It's called 1, 2, 3, 4.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
And the next one was a further attempt to write lyrics. This song is in three verses, and it's called Start, Middle, End, and it's track number 23. So this song's called Blow and Suck. From none
take one, add one, make none to none, add three, take two, make one from one, take n, add s and m, make some from none, take some, make none from none, to some, from some, to none, none, some, more, less, blue, suck, blue, suck. From none, take one, add one, make none, to none, add three, take two, make one, from one, take n, add s, and n. Make some from none, take some, make none from none, to some, from some, to none, none, some more, less. No more, less, yes, from none, to some, to none, add up, get up, take up, make up, keep up, keep up, keep up, keep up, stay up, grow up, give up, let up, and blow, and suck, and blow, and suck, and blow, and suck, and blow, and suck.
Last year or earlier this year, it was, I made it into a bill. wants to work equals the whole world. It was an attempt to write about the work and what exactly happens when you make something. And I find it very difficult to distinguish between things, you know, I mean, I find it difficult to, I mean, in my mind, it's all just a blur, you know, I mean, thoughts, feelings, people, things, the whole world. And this is a neon sign in Clapton, in London. Some people might know this building. It's just at the end of a little cul-de-sac. And I was invited to make something for the building. And I did not feel that I could compete with the building and I didn't want to compete with it, so, and I felt like the entablature was the only place on which I could do something. So I thought about different things that I might write there or do there. In the end I used neon so that it could be seen at night. And I used the phrase, everything is going to be all right, partly because I hope that everything is going to be all right, but also because, it's not a quotation from Bob Marley, it's more like a quotation, it's more like a quotation from everyday usage. And this building was originally built as an orphanage, and it was later, after it was an orphanage, it became the centre of the Salvation Army. It was the headquarters of the Salvation Army, and now it's just a kind of shell. So, thanks very much. Absolutely. You know, I don't find it easy to distinguish. And I think that's partly why I don't think of this as necessary. I mean, it doesn't help me to think about this as being art or not. It's just because it seems like everything's the same. So yeah, I do find that difficult. But you know, I mean, what's important to me about that phrase is that the work is something, and within it, the work is something and nothing. So that I don't think it's that confident.
Our equation's not always confident.
Well, not that one. Well, it's an equation in a way that doesn't add up. But it didn't feel confident. No, it did feel confident. But it felt... And I mean, I was and am confident about it, but not... But I think it's confidently unsure. You know, I mean, it says that the equation the whole world plus the work equals the whole world. That says that the work is nothing. Or it says at least that you can't separate the work from the world. And it's not. And I think that that does not say that the work is this great, important, contained thing, but rather something that exists either, you know, if it does exist, then in people's heads, or in my head, or as something you walk past, or whatever. But, yeah. Anyway, if it is dogmatic, I'm very sorry.
What about the music, though? Maybe that's confidence, in a way, the kind of the aesthetic of music, the kind of aggressive sort of punk rock, maybe, guitarist.
Aye. But if there is that only, yeah, I mean, that exists, it comes about from nervousness, you know.
Yeah, sure.
And right, sorry, say that again.
Well, what, when you're talking about decisions, it seems that with your music, you didn't maybe explain where the aesthetic of the music came from, the style of music that you chose.
Aye.
And I was just wondering about that and whether that was kind of a personality trait or something.
Aye.
Whether there was another sort of schema for the decision making to come in there.
But I mean, the style of the music was not chosen, I don't think. Except in, perhaps in the sense that I can't help what I maybe what I listened to or like what I listened to in the past, but it wasn't really chosen. I mean, a lot of the songs are written simply by sitting down and trying to. A lot of them are written on paper, not with the guitar. You know, one of the problems now that I've been playing guitar a few years. I mean, what I see as a problem partly is that I'm better at playing guitar now. Believe it or not, than I used to be. And the problem now is that if I sit down with a guitar, I can actually play a few things, you know. I can kind of make a nice sound. That was a problem in my mind, in the sense that I can kind of make a nice sound, but I don't. I couldn't understand that, and with a lot of the work I was trying, I'm trying to understand something. So a lot of the music is written on paper. So like this one that went up and down, you know, I wrote it and then I learned how to play it. So I tried to choose what notes to play in the order of them and the composition, the drum, and the bass parts, and then I played it, and often, it was a surprise how it sounded. But maybe the kind of punk thing that you're talking about, that probably is an unavoidable result of the fact that, you know, that drums, and guitar are being used, and it's very simple. More or less punkers. in a way, yeah. I mean, it comes to me from not feeling sure, you know, and not really trusting myself. I mean, you know, I started out painting, trying to paint, and I couldn't get my head, you know, I couldn't, you know, waving your arm around in midair. I wanted to try to understand what was happening, and so I stopped painting, or rather I started sort of designing the paintings beforehand. But although I think that it comes from not feeling sure, from not wanting to choose, I do think that you know that these are decisions. I mean, choosing all the notes on the guitar is a choice, you know. I mean, you know, saying yes and no is an answer. But I don't know whether I've answered your question. You're very far away from me.
For me, that's
is that a formal situation? I don't know.
I think the formality or the formalism that is apparent in the works is saved by your comic timing, I think, in a sense. I mean, there's definitely an element of humour.
But formality, or whatever you want to call it, is unavoidable. I mean, everything has form, doesn't it?
But in the way that if you think of the way, say, someone like Richard Long would make a formal decision of walking in a circle, which in some ways, in a formal sense, is similar to your kind of crunching of a paper into a ball, is a kind of formal kind of comparison there, but.
Yeah.
There is something in all the work that has something like a humour or a manifestation of anxiety that doesn't quite let the formalism be just that.
Right.
It is something else which can save, for me, and save it from being like a Richard Long walk in a circle.
Good. But you know, the squares and the circles are used. I think that I use. You know, there's a lot of squares, a lot of circles, a lot of bilateral symmetry, and they're using. I mean, a lot of the works are symmetrical. I like symmetry because you know, you only have to design half of it. There's less decisions to make. But a lot of the shapes, the squares, the circles, in my mind, are used just as simple solutions to the problem of, like with the masking tape, to make the cube seem to me like the simplest way. Hey? No, not at all. I hate it. No, I do. Sometimes. I like making my thing. I mean, I like making things.
More
like
in the starting point or more?
Hey?
More in the starting point or more in the middle or more
at. But are you talking about actually, you know, using your hands, or are you talking about?
Maybe that's a good point to before you go, I'd just like to remind you that next week Pete Hill is coming same time, same place to talk about lies and superfictions.
But for tonight, I'd like once again to thank Martin Creed for coming.